Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download MinGW compiler and also run your first C program. So let's get started. So MinGW is a compiler for both C and C++ languages. So just go to Google and type download MinGW. You'll be getting this sourceforge.net and here you'll be having MinGW. Just click on that and here you can see that it has about 4 million weekly downloads, so it's completely trustable. And here you will also be having download button, and here also you will be having the instructions for downloading. So just click on this download button. So the download is completed. Just click on open and you will be getting this MinGW installation manager setup. Just click on install. Here you need to select the directory where you want to install. If you want to change it, you can just click on this change button. So I have changed the path and I'll just click on continue and have these things checked. Okay, just click on continue and our download process will first begin. So once everything is downloaded, just click on continue and you'll be getting this MinGW installation manager over here. And in this we need to basically check all the packages that we are going to install. So I need to just click on this checkbox thing and I need to click for mark for installation. Okay, come to the next one, check it and click mark for installation. So do this for everything except Fortran. All right, we don't need Fortran compiler, so just do that for everything except that. If you want, you can also do that, it's totally up to you. If you think you are going to work with Fortran in the future, you can do that, but except that I will go for every other thing. So once you're done selecting, you need to click on this installation option and you need to click on apply changes, and here just click on apply. So the installation will begin now. Once the installation is complete, you will be getting this message: all changes were applied successfully. You may now close this dialog box. So I'll just close this and also I will close our MinGW installation manager. So now we need to add the MinGW path to our environment variable. So for this, we need to go to the folder where we have installed MinGW. So for doing that, the simplest way is just go to search and just type MinGW. You'll be getting this MinGW installation manager app. You need to just click on open file location and here also you'll be having this. Just right click and just click on open file location again. So it will directly take you to the folder where you have MinGW, and here in the top you can see right MinGW is there. Just click on that and here you'll be having this bin and just select this entire path. I hope it made sense. It's basically the default folder where you have installed your MinGW. In most of the cases, it's going to be C, MinGW and bin. All right. So just select that, copy this, control C, and just go to search and now type environment variables. Just click on open. And in this, click on this environment variables, go to path, click on edit, path under system variables, click on new and just paste it. It's going to be local disk C or D MinGW/bin. Alright. So I'm just clicking on OK everywhere. Yeah, here also. And now go to search again. And this time we are going to type command prompt. And let me just now zoom in. So it's going to be, and I will just type G++ space hyphen hyphen version. And if I just hit enter, so we will be getting this G++ MinGW version over here. So in case if you aren't getting this and if you are getting G++ is not recognized or some kind of error, it means that you haven't added the right path to your environment variable. So make sure that you have added the correct path there. And after this, just try running the command gcc hyphen hyphen version. So you'll be getting the gcc version also. This is the one that is going to compile our C program, and G++ is for compiling our C++ program. So now we are done with installing our MinGW compiler. The only thing left is we need to run our first C program. So for this, let me just use my Visual Studio Code editor. So this is the best editor, I guess, for me. You can just download it. So once you have opened Visual Studio Code, just click on file, just click on open folder and just select your desired folder. So let me just go here and click new folder. Let me go with C project. And let me just select this and let me just click on select folder. So currently I'm inside this C project, but it has no files or no contents inside that. So for creating a C program, you'll be having this add file over here. click that, and let me just name the file as newpro.c. So it's small c, so it automatically detects that it's a C program, and just hit enter. So here you can see we will be getting this newpro.c over here. So once you are done creating a file that is a C program, you need to go to extensions and you need to search for C. Just search C and hit enter. And here you will be having this first one as C/C++ extension, and you will be having this extension pack. Yeah, because this comprises of all the three extensions together. I have already installed this extension. If you haven't installed this, you need to just click on install. You will be getting that one over there. So just install this one. And another thing that you also need is code runner. So this also works handy. Yeah, this is also a good extension. You need to just click on install here also. And once you are done installing these things, you need to basically close and reopen your Visual Studio Code. So just close and open. And now let's go and type some C program. Let me just begin with our header file. So it's going to be ash include. It's going to be stdio.h. So here you can see I'm getting the autocomplete or IntelliSense. So you will get this IntelliSense only if you add the extensions. Okay, so just do that. And it's going to be int main, and the next line it's going to be printf, and we just print hello. That's it. And you also need to have a semicolon over here. I'm saving it. And for running this program, there are two ways. So first way is you need to just right click on the file and you need to click on open in integrated terminal. So you need to be making sure that you are inside the right folder, C project. Yeah, I'm inside the C project. So for compiling this, it's going to be GCC space your program name with the extension. So it's going to be newpro.c, and if I hit enter, this gets compiled, and here we will be getting a a.exe file, which is the compiled file. So now if we run this file, we will be getting the output. So for running that a.exe file, we can just use .a and just hit enter. So here you can see I'm getting hello in the output, which is the statement that I'm printing over here. So this is the first way. And the next way is going to be, if you had installed the code runner extension, you will be having a play or run icon over there. And here you need to just click on this drop down, and here you will be having this run code. Just click that run code, and you will be also getting hello in the terminal. And for doing this, you also need to make two other changes. So just go to manage, click on settings. First thing is the font size. So I would recommend you to have 30-40, which is a default or a decent font size, you can say. And after changing the font size, you need to click on extensions. And if you scroll down here, you will be having run code configuration. Click that. And if you scroll down over here, you'll be having run in terminal. Yeah. So you also need to check this thing. Okay, check whether to run in integrated terminal. You need to check this run in terminal thing also. So by this way, you will be able to run your C program in two ways, through the terminal as well as by using the run command over here. So this is it, guys. This is how you install and run your first C program. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, and other CRUD operations, 3D animation using Blender. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.